Hello and welcome back. This week I was trying to make a male character hero. I already have a female character, so I decided to use it as a reference, because the proportions are kind of important for me. I want both of them to be similarly fit, because they will share some items, and they will both be carrying the same backpack, which is gonna be their inventory. I hate it when a character doesn't have any bag or something like that, and yet he is able to carry so much. Like, where does he put everything? That is just my taste. I like when it's more realistic when it comes to world mechanics. Anyway, let's get back to the character. First of all, I have found an all-female sculpt, which as you can see doesn't resemble the low-poly female character that I already use in my game, and that is because I changed the low-poly quite a lot after I started making a texture. I can rarely make a great sculpt that I am pleased with, so I usually make some changes later. So I began resculpting it to resemble a male character. This didn't take a lot of time, the legs and hands are gonna stay very similar, while everything else has to change. I have put extra time on detailing the face. I wanted it to clearly look like a male character. For me it's kind of difficult to see the difference between a guy and a girl when I try Chinese or Korean games. The guys and girls' faces are so similar. I mean, I really have to look at the chest to know exactly if this is a guy or not, so making the face look manly was important for me. So after the high poly model, I made a low poly model in ZBrush. I was trying to make it as low as possible because I want to make this game available for phones as well in the future. Now I know you might think that nowadays phones are capable of running heavy games, but I'm doing a hack and slash type of game, so there might be a lot of enemies on the screen at the same time. After this I prepared a model for baking, and unlike other models, I stretched the islands a lot so that it's easier to create patterns of the clothes. And also this way almost all the area is used for texturing, so it's efficient. Also stretching the UV islands takes a little more time than usual. After this I have exported everything to make bakes. At this point it's as always baking ambient occlusion, normal and curvature map. I have placed all of the maps on top of each other and used gradient layer to apply skin color based on female character. It doesn't matter if it looks strange at first, because it's gonna be fixed while hand painting. And that's what I did next. I started by painting a face. I wasn't completely happy with the result, but it was good enough for now. Then I finished the whole body and also gave him some underwear that is also green. So the base character was done. Now it was time to make some hair. The female character has three different hairstyles, which by the way I'm going to increase in the future. So I decided that I should give him three different hairstyles as well. I was out of ideas what to add, so I came up with probably the worst choices. Now that I look at the result, I'm definitely going to add more hairstyles. But anyway, the process is the same: high poly, low poly and texturing. The only difference is that I made a colorless texture. There will be 7 different colors available to choose, so I just added 7 different gradient layers on top of this black and white texture. So now my character can have a different hairstyle. But that's not all. I still have a few days left this week, so I decided to make different skin colors. This is not as simple as changing the color. It wouldn't be interesting if other features didn't change as well, so I also changed the shape of the eyes, eyebrows and lips. I kind of like the result, so I decided to do the same for the female character. Now it feels more like a modeler pack. After this I thought that I could put this modeler character pack to Unity Asset Store, so that anyone could use them. But some armor is missing, so I will try to make it as fast as possible next week. After this, my next milestone is to make an inventory system, where I will be able to pick and carry items as well as switch body armor, boots or gloves. Anyway, that's it for this week. I hope you liked it. So, see you next time and have a great week.